All right, I want to do a good, thorough documentary, I guess, on the Edison battery I've got here. I got two of these off of eBay. We'll go ahead and do the label plate right there. You can see Edison's profile in that picture. See the face? I don't know what McGraw is at this point, but I'll probably find out with all the interests I've got. So these are Alpha 4 Hotel, A4H size. I made another video that has a manual that'll tell you the different sizes and capacities and things like that. So this came out of a barn, and it had it. There was another battery just like it. It was missing some terminals. Like, these terminals, I believe, are made out of nickel. So sort of exclusive. And what I'm doing is showing you the date code, along with A4H. There's a date code there that I don't know how to read it. There's message boards and stuff. I guess there's somebody at Saft Corporation that has the SAFT that has the date codes, but that's quite an old post. That date code is covered in grease. Or petroleum oil or something. Now the seller said these batteries were full of a fluid that they poured out. I cannot understand that, because by itself it weighs about 65 pounds. And if it was full of a KOH, potassium hydroxide with lithium, it would have been even heavier, and probably no one would want to ship them. But that means that there's probably petroleum jelly on the tops of these. Like, someone put them away, according to the manual, to save them. So I got a lot of cleaning to do. It's kind of moist in there. That's good. I guess they were dumped in March. Right now it's April 2nd, 2017. So if I can get the KOH ready, maybe not much damage will we have done by having sitting empty. Now, unfortunately, the seller left this terminal on with the connection here, and it got bent up and screwed up in the shipping, as you can see. Plus, it's corroded as heck. That's probably not a nickel terminal, but that's not going to be hard to replace. I just got to know what gauge that is. It's a really thick gauge. Now, I really should have a ruler when I'm doing the observation of this battery, but I don't. It's hard to get the scale. This handle here got bent in shipping, but I'm just going to leave it that way. This still functions. I don't want to weaken the metal to bend it back, at least until I know what I'm doing. So I'll zoom up on one of these vent caps here, the cleanest one. Zoom, I mean, get close. Now, if you're buying these, here's some tips. I made a mistake. I bought a single battery because the top kind of looked the same. What I mean by that was the vent cap was offset from center. I didn't see the battery type right there properly, and I assumed it was something else. Well, anyway, what I'm saying is, when you're buying these, try to get the size And if you look at my other video, I have the manual. It'll tell you all the sizes, so you don't make the same mistake that I did. What else? If you can't get the size, here's a little trick. Sometimes they'll shoot photos and stuff. Look for these screws. Like, that'll help you determine if it resembles yours or not. Because in this, there's three screws. And the battery I bought is smaller. By mistake, there's only two screws. And the wood is smaller. And so there's three here and three there. See? See that? That can help you. Also, the vent caps. These vent caps are different from the big cap of the battery I bought. I actually should have that out here. In fact, I'll probably do a full comparison video of what to look for. But pay attention to the vent cap. I think this is a more industrial battery for like trains and vehicles and stuff. The vent cap is different. The other vent cap actually opened. It had a tension type deal. This is just just sits on there. It's got some yuckiness. There's even like moss or something growing on these. or lichen or something. So anyway, I just wanted to do a quick overview. I haven't had time to play with these. I've got a little bit of time here, but first off, I'm gonna be getting the proper KOH percentages, how to measure it, stuff like that. Try to get some lithium hydroxide, I think it's called. I think that's like a accelerant or something. But I guess you don't really need it. And then I've heard about this battery oil stuff that's supposedly made out of like mineral oil. Like a colored mineral oil. So, as I understand, and please comment in the comment section all you know about these. You can put a little bit of mineral, or yeah, the battery oil, which is mineral oil, on the top, and that stops the KOH solution from reacting with carbon, absorbing carbon. So if anybody has any experience on that, that'd be helpful. So basically, I just want to get the knowledge out there. Some people are like, oh, don't tell everybody about these. You know, their supply will dry up. Well, these are made from the beginning of the century to about the middle of the 1970s. So there's got to be a lot out there still. My idea is get the knowledge out there, and maybe some of these will be saved from the scrapyard. People understand what they got. And maybe there'll be like a movement like to restore these things, kind of like a car restoration thing. And indeed, these were used in some of the very first electric cars. So, I just want these to be preserved, their artifacts history, and if they can be returned to functionality, so much the better. That's my intention. But, these are 1.2 volts a cell, and I only have 4. So that does not equal 12 volts. Supposedly they gain voltages and stuff a little higher than 1.2 to maybe they get like 1.7. I don't know, I'll find out. But if not, I've got a radio that'll operate off of 6 volts, so you can manage like that, and I got some other tricks. So anyway, here's my face. Do yourself a favor, subscribe to my channel, and you'll get all the updates. They're not every day, sometimes they're not every month, sometimes they're not... Well, I haven't gone as far as a year without updates, but close. But, stick with it. We'll learn together. Please comment. Because, if you know some info or how to get some info, I'd like to know. Oh, the other thing is, these are nickel iron, okay? Later, I guess Edison Company came up with nickel... Cadmium. Cadmium is a highly dangerous metal. to human life. So I'm not too interested in nickel cadmium. I just want the nickel iron. But this nickel cadmium, I'm sure they've got quite a bit of value as well. In fact, I know I've seen people restore them and stuff. So I want to give a shout out to pretty much everybody that's been playing with these batteries and getting them going. Even the new nickel iron batteries coming out of Europe and China and whatnot. At least, I mean, my opinion is at least they're trying, you know, sometimes succeeding, I guess. I'm not sure. But the reason why I'm in love with these things is they're really durable. I mean, they're in a steel box, right? I mean, they survived FedEx. So, and if you do the research, Edison really tested the you-know-what out of these. They're meant to be, like, super durable, and they are. And the newer nickel-iron batteries and stuff come in plastic cases, whatnot, and I think they're a little bit more fragile. And I just say, if you're gonna do replica batteries, go all the way. You know, it might cost quite a bit more, but do it all the way. Make batteries the way they were, you know, were supposed to be made. Unless you really do have a better technology. But the way I look at it, these are already supposedly proven. So I'll go with proven. They're expensive. Like, I paid quite a bit, about $100 a cell. You can, you know, if you buy these replicas and stuff, you're gonna be paid. It looks like a lot of the importers are really, you know, making their commission and whatnot. But hey, you know, the important thing is they're coming back into. Coming back into style. So apparently I like vintage stuff, so there we go. But so I want to give a shout out to Backwoods Hillbilly, I think it is. I hope I got that right. He's been really doing stuff with these, and he kind of like convinced me kind of to buy these, you know, not directly, but just through his videos. And I'll put a link to his channel in my descriptions. So yeah, I mean, like, some of this knowledge and stuff, you gotta go back into the people to work with it, and some of them are the people that you would overlook in some cases. You know, people that have to learn about this technology because they use it, right? So I wanna give a shout out to a bunch of other folks that I can't remember their YouTube titles, unfortunately. Like, I'm like sleep deprived and stuff, so I apologize. But yeah, so anyway, so this is Military Industrial Museum. This is sort of the museum section, right? We're looking at something old. So hopefully I'll have time to really get down and dirty and do the proper restoration. And hopefully you'll be along for the ride. But if anybody's got, what I'd really like to do, you can start on this if you want, or so your own channel or whatever. But in the comments, maybe list sources for these. Like, if someone wants to have some to sell, maybe I should make a new video for that or whatever. Maybe, I don't know. Just play with it. You can list in the comments, and then maybe people that are interested get a hold of these. If you want to get a hold of these, your best chance to do that is either eBay or Craigslist. And not the Craigslist, but there's like third-party search engines that take Craigslist and like do a complete search of like the whole U.S. I think it's called Olive Craigs or Ad Hunter or something like that. There's different ones. Some are better than others. But they'll give you a complete rundown of all the sellers of these type of batteries in the U.S. at that time. And Yeah, if you can afford the cells, which I think they run about $100 a piece for each 1.2. And then you can figure out the shipping and stuff, you'd be in good shape. So anyway, I want to fit a few more YouTube videos before this day's out. So it's Sunday, April 2nd, 2017, and thank you for spending your time with me, and hopefully this was valuable to you, and please have a good day.